Jurassic Park Marathon continues, baby! And today, we are listening to the Lost World soundtrack. Oh yeah! Is this soundtrack better or worse than the first one? I don't know. That's a good question. They're both so different, yet so similar. The first one has this very timeless, awe-inspiring adventure... awe-inspiring wonderment and to it, and some thrills. This one has that adventure jungle feel to it, and I don't know which one I like more because they're both so different, but yet they're so similar because they're both Jurassic Park and they both feel like Jurassic Park. And I love it they just didn't cheap out and reuse the theme from the last movie when they made the sequel. I love it they actually went and actually recomposed an entirely new soundtrack that doesn't just reincorporate everything from the first movie. That is awesome. John Williams, Spielberg, and Michael Crichton, you three are geniuses. Geniuses, I love all of you. Spielberg, you're my favorite director. Crichton, you're my favorite author. And Williams, you're my favorite composer. Let's listen to this soundtrack. That very jungle feel. I love this theme, yes. Connect, don't look at my hands. I'm not telling you what to do. No, I'm not. No, my God, what am I talking about? That was bad, yes, it was, yeah. Here we go again, yeah. The soundtracks of two. A good start, yes, yes. I mean, don't you just want to get excited when you hear this theme? I mean, listen to it. Listen to it! Don't you just want to get excited when you hear this? Don't you just want to go run into the woods somewhere and just like... just imagine you're on some kind of awesome adventure? God, I love this theme! Spielberg, he knows how to open up his movies, man. Am I creeping you out? I don't mean to. Just like the first movie has that unique opening. Very, very good. Very cool. Now my personal favorite track. Malcolm's Journey. I can't tell you how many stories this track has helped me come up with. And, well, I'm trying to write books now. Gotta turn the stories I come up with into books instead of movies. I think it'll be pretty cool. Dun 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 dun. That is just in the movie when that part happens, it's like the movie just turns up the gears and we're on an adventure now. And you see Ian Malcolm's daughter Kelly look at the map, and you see Isla Sorna on there, and bam, we're on the boat, and we're getting that awesome 360 shot of the boat, and then we turn around, and we see the island, man. It's so awesome, and why do people hate this movie? Why? Cell phone? I armed it with pepper acid, you know, most powerful neurotoxin on the planet. Acid in the neurotoxin velocity. So the animal's down for you, just, yeah, on the target. Sorry, how'd I do? Oh, you mean like if you shot yourself in the foot? No, don't do that. You definitely realize you had an accident. I don't know, hold on. Now, he's heard too many stories about this island chain, and he wants to drop us off and go somewhere offshore. Hold on, he's heard stories about a fisherman that got too close to the island and never returned. They call the island Venezuela. Si. Oh, what's that mean? Five deaths, he says. Yeah, I've seen this movie too many times. I don't get it. Why do people hate this freaking movie? Vince Vaughn's actually good in it. Julianne Moore is awesome. The guy that plays Eddie, I forget your name, but you're awesome too. That scene with you pulling the freaking trailers back over the cliff, that scene is amazing. And nowadays, you know, that'd be some stupid set where they'd shoot it, you know, with CGI. No, Spielberg hung a freaking trailer 40 feet off the ground, off a building. I just blew your mind, didn't I? And that's how they filmed the scene. There's that awesome shot where he's outside the trailer, and then it goes inside the trailer. One shot still, and we see everyone hanging down. You know how much preparation that should have taken to do? I love this movie! And now we see the awesome trailers and the awesome cars. Here we go. This is the part when the trailer scene, man. The trailer scene is on par with when the T-Rex first comes out of its paddock in the first Jurassic Park. I mean, these scenes are some of the most suspenseful scenes I've ever seen in my entire life. I mean, I watched this movie like a month ago. I was on the edge of my seat like the entire time. And I was actually looking for flaws. I couldn't find them. Wire hook, man, he's got his freaking standard car in reverse. He's got all the gears going. He's freaking reversing that shit. He's trying to pull the freaking trailer back over the cliff. Man, that scene, I can't. Yeah, I know I'm praising this movie so much. I might as well just review it for Christ's sake. But I love this movie, and this soundtrack just helps. Worst part. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. And we had two T-Rexes instead of one. Ah, here we go. We got Hammond's plan. His plan. He's always got a plan. It's not a resource expedition anymore. It's a rescue operation that's leaving right now. Oh, just a quick message to Microsoft. Can you please add support for the CD? For playing audio CDs in the Xbox One for this remote. It's kind of annoying that I gotta use my game controller to actually control the app. I mean, I can go next and back, but that's about it. I can't actually control the app with this. I don't know why. It's pretty friggin' retarded. And I'm not using my PS3 to play music, because then you're gonna hear that droning noise on the PS3. When we play the Lost World video game next, then I'll use the PS3, and you'll hear that droning noise whether you like it or not. This music's very mysterious. The Stegosaurus scene gives me goosebumps every time. Through it, obviously. I'm not going to listen to an entire soundtrack because you guys are going to get bored of sitting me sitting here talking about how awesome the soundtrack is, but... And... Dun-dun! This movie is... Awesome! Well, guys, that's about all I'm going to do with this video. Hope you like that. Go out and buy the fucking soundtrack. Support the official release. Do not pirate music. Go out and buy the goddamn CD or buy it on iTunes. Don't pirate. Because that's why things like SOPA try to exist. Your actions have a cause and effect. I got this for $5 on Amazon. If you can't afford to shovel out $5, you're a cheap piece of shit, and you're exactly what's wrong with the world. Anyway, make sure to comment and subscribe, guys. And remember, I got more content for Derek Listens coming. We got the Jurassic Park 3 soundtrack. And if I do Jurassic World, don't expect that till after I see the movie. Because I had to buy the soundtrack and actually listen to it in its entirety first. But Jurassic Park 3, I don't own the physical copy anymore, but I had the whole soundtrack on my computer from the physical copy I used to own. Because why would I own something for Jurassic Park 3? That movie's a piece of crap. But we'll talk about that another time, because this is The Lost World, and it's an awesome sequel, and thank you for watching, guys. Like I said, comment, subscribe, and peace out.